Hello, friends. I'm cooking. So, very grateful that I have time to cook today. And I just thought people might want to see what I'm making. So, again, this is not really a recipe that I found somewhere. It's something that I just made up. So you can hear what I have going here. Some organic extra firm tofu, cooking in some safflower oil. More on that later. I have some onions with a little bit of safflower oil and soy sauce, slow cooking, caramelizing. Then I have some parsnips with sesame seed oil, green onions, and a little bit of soy sauce, slow cooking. They're gonna get all caramelized as well. Very good root vegetable to be eating in the winter time to keep you warm, to give you strong energy, to make you feel rooted. And here, you're gonna get a different, okay. And I'm gonna might be better if they're like this. Try to go under the tofu so you don't make the cubes messed up. And turn it so it can cook on another side. Wow. What we are making with the slow cooked onions right here is polenta. And organic polenta. And this is how I like to make it usually. Sometimes I just make it in the pan with sesame oil and soy sauce. But I like, honestly, caramelized onions to anything makes it 10 times better. So that's what I'm going to do with the polenta. And then with the tofu, I think we can continue with the tofu. This is my favorite way recently that I just made up to make tofu. So, so good. So here, first I just cook it a little bit and turn it in the oil. Be careful not to mess up the cube shape. You can add more oil if you want to. I'm not sure that I will. Try not to eat too much oil. Okay, then I add a little bit of soy sauce. Just a tiny bit. Then I shake it around. Get the party started. Uh-oh. I think one of my Black Friday orders is coming in from Cloud and Victory. Super cool ballet
clothing line. Yes! Purchase from Black Friday. That's gonna be an unboxing. Maybe on my live, Instagram live, or maybe on my YouTube channel. For sure on my YouTube channel. Young Living. Okay, let's put this right here. Yeah, I'm about that essential oil life now. Okay. All right, so I think it's time we turn these tofu cubes around. All right, shaky, 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 shaky. All right, next thing for these is gonna be some rice vinegar. And rice vinegar is sweeter, so it's a way to sweeten your food that you don't have to use sugar. Okay, so just a little bit. Distributed evenly. All right. There you go. And then shakey, shakey. And then turny, turny. Very carefully, girl. All right. Shakey, shakey. Okay. Then, P.S. When I saw the mailman come up with my package, he saw me dancing. And then when I opened the door, I said, what did I say? Did you guys hear me? I said, just not Virginia. And then he didn't really react. People, just be yourself. Most people don't care. So just be yourself, even though you may think like, oh, you're gonna think I'm weird. Most people are not even paying attention to you, girl. Okay, and then let's continue. Okay, for the tofu, the last ingredient we add is the Trader Joe's chili lime seasoning. The magic ingredient, girl. You're gonna go shaky, 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 shaky. And then, so I'm gonna show you how it would look. Like this, okay? Then we're gonna, you guessed it, turn it around. Turn the beat around. Da, 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 da. Turn the tofu down. Just keep turning it until they're like more evenly coated. And then, oh yeah, oops. And then, just keep them cooking. Just keep them cooking. I put it on the lowest flame. So now we continue back to this pan with the onions that we're caramelizing. And then we get our polenta ready. All right. So, polenta, polenta. Hey, girl. Come on, girl. There we go. Polenta on the chopping board. Hello. Hello, sister. Okay. All right. So get the knife. And I, because I just make this for myself. I don't feed anybody else except for Minnie, but I feed her leftovers. So I'm not counting Minnie in here. Anyways, so I cut this polenta in half and see how it's so nice on the packaging. It's like already kind of helps you split it in half and you go, water's gonna burst out of here, just so you guys know. Slice it. Then you can save one half for later, but cover it with like a paper towel
and put it in the refrigerator because otherwise it grows mold. All right, then this one, you just unpeel it. This is my favorite part. Okay, you know they use polenta in that Lush cleanser, Let the Good Times Roll? So that is key information. In 1 second, you're gonna see. Then, where should I put you? Right here. You can't really see what I'm gonna do. Basically, you're just gonna mash the polenta in your hands and put it in the pan. And honestly, I already feel, if you're clairsentient, if you know what that is, you already feel the good vibes from the corn on your hands, and you already start to feel like... Okay, so yes, and then you just take off the little excess that's on your hands, put it in the pan, and now this is the best part. The best part is not eating it, girl. The best part is washing this off your hands. Because I told you, if you're clairsentient, you already feel the good vibes from the cornmeal. But then you get the actual feeling of the grain massaging your skin. And like I said, they use it in the cleanser at Lush Let the Good Times Roll. Look at the good times roll. You can wash your face with it, or... Okay, now I have to bring you to the sink. Or you could just... Watch me. I'm just gonna rub my hands together right here, and it feels amazing. It feels really, really good. So, so good. And you just rub it in, and you're in heaven, honestly. Try it. Don't knock it until you try it, girl. Try it. And you just rub, 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 and you have a million tiny orgasms, and it's great. And you can just be here as long as you want to. You know, depending. And then when you go in between your fingers too, girl, next level. And then the back of your hands, because that's what people see, or the palms of your hands, because that's how you give love. Your heart chakra ends in your hands. It goes down through your arms to your hands. That's also how you can feel better. If you're trying to work on your clairsentience, that's how you can pick up on vibes more easily. So, then with warm water, you just rinse it off. All right, and then I still feel good vibes. And then you dry your hand, and then you can't really tell the difference because I didn't show you before, but your skin is softer, it looks brighter. Anyways, back to the cooking part. So, yes, and I try not to use the same like thing, like spatula between all the things. I try to keep one spatula is for this, one spatula is for that. You feel me? So you don't like cross, you know? And then you just stir it around, and you can break up the polenta chunks a little bit more if you want to see how it looked like this. You can break them up a little bit more if you want to. I just do it a little bit because I kind of like that they're a little bit chunky. And then at this point, you can turn up the heat. The onions were on the low flame to help caramelize them. That's how you get onions to caramelize, is on a low flame. But now that I added the polenta, I kind of just, you don't really even need to cook polenta because it's honestly, it's just cornmeal. So, but just to heat it up, I just turn up the heat a little bit more. Just like medium flame. And then I just stir it around, you know, stab the chunks, spin it. And when you cook, the energy that you put into your food, like, you know, by how your mood is, how your thought is, how your feelings are, Also, in that way, but also like the stirring energy that you put into your food. You consume it later. So it's a really good idea to, you know, try to think positive, think about like, oh, this food is gonna nourish me, this food is gonna sustain me, this food is gonna help me feel better. Like, think like that. And then, so if you stir the food faster, it kind of gives you like this kind of energy, like, come on, let's move like faster. Feel me? But if you stir it slowly, that's the kind of energy good that goes into it. You feel me? So, pushing it around a lot. And plus, I have it on higher heat, so it's gonna heat up faster, it's gonna cook faster, so the energy is gonna be, you know, faster, like I told you, like in a short amount of time, faster, like that. So, yes, so it's a little bit different. Oh, okay, I have to go back to the tofu, because I forgot about it. Okay, let's go back to the tofu. All right, so the tofu, okay. Tofu has been sitting here. I'm gonna turn it around so it goes to another side. It's on low flame, so it's not like they got burned or anything, but the reason why I keep the tofu on low flame and not covered is so that the water evaporates, so it gets more dry. Because I'm the kind of person that likes firm tofu, like not really mushy tofu. I mean, unless it's already in a dessert, you feel me? But mostly I just like firm tofu. So before I even put it in the pan, I put paper towels, I try to take out as much water as I can. So, and also too, I leave it low flame to keep it warm while I finish cooking my rest of my food, because I like to eat most of the time warmer food. Feel me? Okay, so basically, I'm done with my food now. I'm done making it. I pushed it around. Oh, honestly, what you can do with the polenta, you can put a little bit more soy sauce if you want. I don't think I'm gonna do that today. I already have salty, you feel me? So I don't want to overdo it. So I'm done with the polenta, done. I turned off the tofu. Now the only thing left, and this is how I cook. I cook, and this is how I try to just do everything in my life, is guided by intuition. So like I said, none of these things that I'm making, I didn't get from a recipe. So the last thing that I have is my parsnips, and I told you that I'm slow cooking them. So slow cooking is gonna take a longer time. It's gonna be on a lower flame, it's gonna be covered. And like I said about the energy, this style of cooking is really good for winter time, where you wanna keep more warm because it's colder outside. So this style of cooking is more yang-izing. So that's a good way to cook, like I said, in the winter. And also too, if you're trying to ground yourself, if you're feeling like a little bit disconnected from your body, like too like dreamy, which that's my problem, I tend to go there. I mean, I am a Pisces moon and Virgo sun, so, not Virgo sun, Cancer sun, plus just being a female, plus just consuming a lot of medication and sugar and coffee in my life, I need more grounding. So anyways, so this is, smells good. This is how it is right now. I'm not sure. I think I'm gonna leave it for a few more minutes. The longer you leave it, the longer, like, because I have onions in there and I have a root vegetable that's more sweet, it's gonna get even sweeter. It's gonna get even more caramelized. So I think I'm gonna leave it a little bit longer, just a few more minutes. I'm gonna clean up my little kitchen space, you know, put away my stuff, clean it, you know, But so then after I'm gonna probably turn off the parsnips. But yeah, that's my lunch today, and most of the time my afternoons this time is the time where I have the most free time. So that's when I can cook. That's when I can eat properly, because otherwise in the morning it's like in the evening I usually work or I do class, so it's like, so the afternoon is the best time for me to make time to cook and to eat properly. So very thankful for these days when I have time. But anyways, thanks for watching this video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Peace, and also think differently. Hello, I didn't see people are commenting. Hello. Bye.